Is it live sessions that you guys are doing? Is it pre-recorded?
I was just going to say, this is, I think, my favorite part of all this is that we're doing these live.
Right.
And one of the first kind of things we ask in a Slido is, where are you in the world right now? And the response is amazing. Like, people from around the world tuning in, well, not tuning in, signing in to watch us do our little sessions on technology and CCNA.
So in other words, don't get intimidated.
I think that's my message, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Not be intimidated. It's doable, yeah. Right? There are so many people around the world.
I mean, the fact that I paused is a miracle, I'm joking.
I had to do it twice.
Did you?
I did.
That's an encouragement for all of us, right? Because all of us have failed exams.
Oh, for gosh, sure. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
definitely.
And that's my word of advice for everybody is passion, patience, and perseverance.
People watching can get free training from two really experienced instructors who are passionate about the technology, and it doesn't cost anything. It's amazing.
Everyone, it's David Bommel back with some amazing guests, Patrick, Hank, Matt. Welcome. Great to have you guys on the show. So Matt, let's start with you. CCNA, big updates. Perhaps you can just tell the audience a little bit about yourself and tell us what's going on with CCNA.
Yep. Thank you, David, for having us on. My name is Matt Saunders. I'm a community manager for the Cisco Learning Network community, which is part of the Learning and Certifications organization at Cisco. And currently, I have the very high privilege to work with these two gentlemen on
a program. I don't know if I agree with that, but especially with Hank, but sorry, go on.
On a program for CCNA candidates. It's our CCNA prep program, a free program for learners, candidates that are just about ready to sit for the exam. So they've completed the bulk of their learning and they want to kind of validate their exam readiness.
That's great.
And so we're in season two of this program with Hank and Patrick. And basically what they do is they present exam-like questions and then they go into the questions. They get into the weeds with the technical aspects behind the questions and why the right answer is the right answer.
So I hope you guys are going to share some technical stuff, right?
Oh, during the webinars or the streams and the events that are going on, it's all technical. Like, that's the whole point to go through is... A big part of earning your certification, becoming a network engineer, is having those hands-on skills, like putting that concept to practice. So we present the multiple choice questions to help people on the exam, but we show the reason. As an example, this week we did a live session here at the event on DNS.
Okay.
Right. So on the CCNA.
Always DNS.
Yeah, it's always DNS.
Yep.
The topic on the exam blueprint is explain the role DNS plays in the network.
Yep.
It's explain. It's not configure. It's not troubleshoot. But my belief is always to explain it, it's really good to see it in action, to understand how it works. And so we spent the entire time diving through it, doing DNS lookups, understanding, following packets as that we had a packet capture, for gosh sakes, right?
At CCNA level, I like
at
it.
At the CCNA level. So that's the focus, is always to kind of put these things into practice so people can see that the skills actually have value with what they're going to have to do in the real world.
And when we're looking at the CCNA exam topics, right, we quickly see that a bunch of them say configure this, configure that. And that was the inspiration for this series. So season one was all about kind of back to networking basics. So VLANs, trunks, static routing, OSPF, and the community just over the heels for this kind of stuff. And we didn't stop there. So season two is all about network services.
And there's a lot of network services that are out there. My personal favorite, and I'll go on record, is DNS. It's got to be my favorite network service. Love me some DNS. We put it in here because I've been waiting for years to do a deep dive into DNS, and this gave me at least the chance to start. And then we'll go into NAT. We're going to go into NTP. We're going to see these services. And if we're lucky, we'll get picked up for season three and be able to come back for security-related topics.
We'll have to talk to management, see if our contract gets renewed. So.
And I think it's important to talk about the platform that you're using for the demos. So while you're demoing primarily in Cisco Modeling Labs, Patrick also typically makes a packet tracer file available for the learners that are attending the sessions to either follow along or to kind of follow up and perform the same activities after the session.
Is it live sessions that you guys are doing? Is it pre-recorded?
I was just going to say, this is, I think, my favorite part of all this is that we're doing these live.
Right.
And one of the first kind of things we ask in a Slido is, where are you in the world right now? And the response is amazing. Like, people from around the world tuning in, well, not tuning in, signing in to watch us do our little sessions on technology and CCNA.
So you two are presenting, right? And then you present Pete, before the time someone can get the CML file or the packet tracer file and then follow along?
Yeah, I'd love to say that we were that far in advance prepared. generally, we publish the files usually a couple of days before the live stream, but we always let folks know, hey, they're available, you can download them. We don't want people to try to do it as we go. We want them to watch and then take those. I'll also say that we always generate way more lab content and hands-on than we have time. And so the lab guides typically have exercises we don't get to. So they can download the CML or the packet tracer and dive through them, go through them on their own time, replicate, go through on that side. Because I'm a firm believer, hands-on is the way you learn stuff, right?
And again, maybe we're not there to cover that last bit of the lab. The guide that we've created that is in the YAML file, in the CML file, has all the details about the lab, kind of step-by-step, configure this, check that, is this working? The reaction from folks has just been fantastic.
So hold on a minute, you doing live training, right? So someone can attend live at certain times, but it's recorded,
absolutely. Yes,
yeah.
Absolutely.
So if I miss the session, I can watch the video.
Yes.
There are lab files that I can download.
Yes.
And there's a lab guide.
Did you say? Yeah. We write the step-by-step guides.
Exactly.
And in the CML side, we embed it in the CML platform as the guide that's there. Packet tracers come through the instructions. And then we generally also create a PDF of just the guide so people can look at that separate if they want and see what's in place. Because we want people to answer the questions, understand what's there, have the opportunity to do this themselves, not just watch somebody else do it.
And how often are you doing it? Is it like once a month or?
But basically about every 2 weeks. So up about bi-weekly, and we've done six in season one. And
seven.
Seven in season one, and seven or six in season two, do you know?
Seven, I
What's
think.
The count?
Seven?
I think it'll be seven. Especially if we go back to DNS, if we do a part two, perhaps, we'll see. But yeah.
One of my personal favorite things about the program is these two have just, I don't know if you can tell here, but they have fantastic chemistry together when they do the sessions. They bounce off each other really, really well. And I think it makes the learning a little more fun, right? Than just kind of sitting at home by yourself, kind of maybe watching something by a solo speaker, solo presenter. So they're really fun and engaging. So I think that's one of the really nice things about the sessions as well.
Okay, most important question, how much does it cost?
Well, besides my tip that I typically collect after the sessions, in a post-event follow-up.
That's a joke.
They're absolutely free. Yep, they're absolutely free. And we just want folks to build their confidence level going into the exams. And so we put these together for folks.
I think one of the advantages of doing it with Hank as two instructors live is that as he's, let's say, demoing something, I'm checking chat.
That's great.
I'm looking at chat, responding to questions with Matt as well. We've got a few people helping with that. And so we just kind of bounce roles. And so one episode, I'll lead the episode. So like a couple of weeks ago, I did DHCP and Hank was taking care of chat and making sure that everything was rolling smoothly. And then yesterday we did a live version of this here at the Cisco U Theater. Hank was driving. I was a passenger. Well, maybe not passenger, the right word. I was co-pilot, making sure the chat was happy. And so it's been really, it's a fun formula, I think, that we've hit on.
How long have you guys been training? Like, being an instructor, it must be years now.
Yeah.
Oh, Hank, yeah.
You look older than me, man. It's getting up there. My white hair is showing up. I've been looking recently back at some of the stuff we've done earlier. And I was like, boy, I had far less gray at the time. I mean, if I count training experience on that side, I'm up at 12 years probably of kind of where it's been a big part of the focus work that I'm after on that side. But I've got nothing on this guy next to me.
I was going
to
say, you've been training for years.
Yes. Well, again, the cliche that the CCNA changed my life, it did. The high school I was teaching back in 2000, I was teaching programming, became a networking academy. And I got my CCNA through that. And so I've been an Etacad instructor off and on for 25 years. And became a CCSI back in 2005. So that's 20 years. So I've been around, but you can see I still love it. I still enjoy teaching. And I know, again, cliche, changing people's lives. Because I think we're doing that, honestly.
But the reason I ask that question, right, is people watching can get free training from two really experienced instructors who are passionate about the technology. And it doesn't cost anything. It's amazing. So, Matt, do I thank you for putting this together?
Actually, it started even before me, but I have the honor of kind of helping to carry it forward and keep the momentum going for the program. So I'm just honored, genuinely honored to be able to participate and support the program.
So, Matt, I need to ask you this as well. You run the Cisco community, is that right?
Yes, that's correct. The Cisco Learning Network community.
So what is that about?
So it's all about supporting folks that are going for their certifications at any level. And so we help a lot of folks at the CCNA level primarily come in as you're getting started. How do I get started? What do I study? What are the best methodologies for studying? What are the best resources for studying? And they're really forming a community and staying connected throughout the people's careers, really.
Yeah.
We have an ambassadors program for our top contributors and a VIP program as well for both our top contributors that are also certified at a certain level. So there's a really healthy wealth of knowledge and just fantastic people that are there to support the rest of the community. And it's also a true privilege and pleasure to get to work on that community.
I love that. And also, I wanted to ask, the reason I asked that question again is, let's say I attend one of the sessions and I'm confused. I'm not sure about something. Do I go to that community? Where do I get help?
The whole general community, yes, for sure. But we do also create specific discussion threads for each session.
That's correct.
And once you register for the session, the follow-up emails that you receive have all of those key links. So yeah, to come back and be able to ask Hank and Patrick follow-up questions after the session, get the lab files, etc. It's really pretty
sometimes
powerful.
We get very specific, in-depth questions. We don't quite have time to cover it in our session. That community, right? That discussion forum is great. We can go in, you know, answer it properly, have a bit of a conversation, make sure that the learner understands, right?
Yeah.
And gets a sense of what that problem was.
And I think the community aspect has always been the most impressive thing for me. Many of us as network engineers, we sit there and the job is solo. We're in a room, sometimes it's a closet, sometimes it's a data center, and you're all by yourself. But the communities that we have, the learning community, your community that you have, David, what we've done all over the place, like that's the opportunity to remember you're not alone. There's other people doing this. We all love the feeling when that ping turns into an exclamation point instead of a dot. It's such a good feeling.
I was just going to talk about like the expansion of the questions that come in throughout the session, right? Like Patrick mentioned, yesterday you got a great question in the chat that wasn't really necessarily in the scope of the 30-minute presentation, but you did a fantastic job explaining the question a little bit deeper for the person that submitted that question. It was about DNS...
spoofing attack or something like that.
It was a specific DNS security related question.
Was. Yeah.
So that's really one of the nice things as well, to have access to these experts, both live and afterwards as well.
I was going to say, I mean, to get live training, a lot of places charge a lot of money for that. And it's great that you guys are, you know, giving that to free for the community where they can access your knowledge live. And like you said, afterwards, also as part of the Cisco community, ask questions. So Matt, any other cool stuff that you guys are doing before we wrap up?
I think the other really exciting thing right now is the Rev Up to Research program.
Yeah, what's that?
So it's another opportunity for free learning where folks that complete the learning, they earn their continuing education credits to keep their certifications active. It's a great opportunity. It's through our Cisco U platform, which is where all of our digital learning is delivered. And the current program is on AI and AI readiness for infrastructure environments. And it's just really fantastic learning and course on top of the continuing education credits. And we do those, I think we're on about a quarterly cadence right now. And so that's just another great program that's available right now. And I think that one ends middle of March. And we're currently middle of February, so got a little about a month or so left for folks to go to get that one, and then are kind of signed up to receive the information for the next Rev Up program as well.
I was going to put you on the spot. If you were starting today, right? CCNA, got to ask this question.
Yeah.
I'm nervous. CCNA looks scary. You know, what's your...
Because of the scope of the CCNA?
Yeah, like, or just seems where it's... Seems complex, a lot of technologies.
It is.
It's supposed to be a difficult exam. You know, what's your advice? What, you know, if you... Give me one piece of advice to wrap up from each of you. What would it be?
I'll start. So I'm actually going through this right now. My son is 15 and is interested in technology on those sides. And he's seen me work at Cisco for his entire life. And he's like, I want to be a CCNA. And I said, that's great. Start with this new CCST programs that we have. So through our NetAcad, we've got the kind of the introduction to networking. And so he was able to actually set it up with his school so he could do that as a grade, go through the program. He's finished it. He's going through the review now. And so he's going to go sit for the CCST networking as a nice entry point. Because if you truly are brand new to networking, the CCNA is fantastic, but it is a big program.
It's a big, the first step is quite big.
So I would say start with CCST, Cisco certified. It's still a Cisco certification, but Cisco Certified Support Technician, networking, and we have them for IT support and cybersecurity as well.
Yeah. Is that paid? Is it free? Or
the training is free.
And where's that available?
Netacad.com.
Yep. Through Netacad. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We also have that same training also in our Cisco U platform, but I agree that for a lot of people, that first step is intimidating. It's daunting. The exam blueprint, I agree, it's vast. And what I mean by that is it doesn't go in depth in one thing. It's touching on a bunch of things. And obviously, you've hit on this over the last few months. AI has appeared in the blueprint as well. So don't be intimidated by it. Look at the verbs also, right? It's explain, it's describe. We're just asking you to get familiar with some of these things. Obviously, the ones that are configure, verify, and troubleshoot, those are more advanced topics. And so that's why we're focusing on those on the CCNA prep program. The other ones are at a higher level. And so we're just asking you to become familiar with those concepts, even though they are a bit challenging.
So in other words, don't get intimidated.
I think that's my message. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Not be intimidated. It's doable, yeah. Right? There are so many people around the world.
I mean, the fact that I paused is a miracle. No, I'm joking.
I had to do it twice.
Did you?
I did.
That's an encouragement for all of us, right? Because all of us have failed exams.
Oh,
for
gosh, sure. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
definitely.
And that's my word of advice for everybody is passion, patience, and perseverance. So you have to have the interest, but you also have to be patient. You have to give yourself time, and you have to be willing to persevere past the hard moments of, oh my gosh, I do not understand what a VLAN subnetting is,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Subnetting is the favorite, right?
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.
But believe in yourself that if you stick with it and you give yourself enough time, you will achieve it. If Hank had to sit for it twice, it's okay if you have to sit for it more than once, and you'll be in a situation, you know, next year, you'll know so much more than you knew starting today. So stick with it.
David, I think the big difference between when you and I did it and students doing it today, think back what material you had to study and how very basic it was.
Much less than now.
And look at what we have offer now, video and interactive training and, you know, online labs and packet tracer. I mean, the tools are there. So we have different types of learners, and hopefully we're hitting different ways that those learners can learn with this different type of material that we have.
But I love it. I mean, live training, amazing.
Yep.
Labs, lab guides.
Yep.
It's amazing. You can replay the videos, and there's a community, and you guys actually answer the questions after the fact and during the live session. I mean, it's amazing. So big question is, okay, where do I go?
So Cisco Learning Network community, we'll provide links for the video
as
well.
I'll put it below the video. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yep. But Cisco Learning Network community, do a search for CCNA prep or CCNA live streams, and it'll get you right to the right section of the site for that. And sign up, the little sign up form, pop your name in there and your email address, and you'll get all the follow-up information for it.
Guys, thanks so much for sharing, you know.
Thanks.
And giving back to the community. I mean, I love it. I mean, Hank, we've done videos in the past together. Patrick, we're going to have to do some. Matt as well, we've got to get you on the channel. You know, it's fantastic to see how, you know, the old days versus today. There's, like you said, there's so much available and so much available for free.
Yeah.
Really appreciate it, guys. Thanks so much.
My pleasure.
Thank you, David. Cheers.